So I would tell my first year self not to worry so much.
Try as many different things as she could.
I would tell myself, judge people less and accept people for who they are.
I would tell my first year self to branch out.
Take time for yourself. Don't be so hard on yourself. It's really important to take breaks, especially for your mental health.
You can do way more than you think that you're capable of.
Don't let people discredit your ideas because of your age. Really, young people have the power for the future.
Focus on activities both inside and outside class.
When everybody is so fixated on the whys in your life and your choices, turn around and ask them why not and keep moving forward.
I found the McMaster really taught me a lot about community values, and I'm really community-minded now because of it.
McMaster has shaped me as a person by introducing a very rigorous work ethic in me.
McMaster has made me a lot more independent, and I've learned a lot from my professors outside of engineering, just how to manage teams and work in large groups.
So Mac shaped the person I am today a lot. I've done a lot of growing up during my time here, and I think really I would be a completely different person if I'd gone to any other school.
My time here at McMaster, everyone's just so welcoming within the engineering faculty and just all around campus and within different groups and clubs I've been a part of. And that's really helped shape me and who I've become and the friendships I've made throughout my experience here.
I am very introverted, and I feel like during the last 5 years I've completely broken out of my shell. Just from making different friends and joining different clubs and teams, I've gotten a chance to completely change that side of my personality.
Yeah, but if I can narrow it down to a word, I think stronger.
There are things like communication and leadership and applied technical skills to really tough problems. So
I've been here for 10 years, actually. This is my second degree. McMaster has helped me grow not only professionally, but also personally.
I got it in the mail and they told me, you got in. And I, as soon as I got that, I didn't even look at the other university offers. I was like, you know what, this is it.
When I received my offer, I was very excited. McMaster was my top choice at that point, so it was very reassuring to know that I would be able to have my choice if I wanted to go to McMaster.
I was by myself at home, sitting at my computer, and I literally screamed really loudly. I think I accepted the offer probably within an hour, because I already knew McMaster was where I wanted to come.
I remember the moment I received my McMaster offer letter, and I was overjoyed. And I remember receiving scholarship offers and crying because I couldn't believe that I had done that and I accomplished that.
It was one of the happiest days of my life. Got into my first choice program.
A not so great day in the office when I took out the mail that I picked up in the morning before I went to work, and I opened up that letter and it said that I had a position at McMaster. It opened up so many more opportunities, so many more doors, and it led me to the job that I'm in right now.
I was super excited because it was the last one that I was waiting for and I was hoping for it, so I was just super excited. That's the one I was set on from like the time I was in grade 9, so it was like a really, really exciting moment.